Hey there, folks. My name is Mr. Moomin11, and today we're going to be building one of the best SMG loadouts for you to start running on Warzone and Rebirth Island. With the fastest fire rate of any weapon in Modern Warfare or Cold War, the MAC-10 just absolutely shreds through enemies. And while there are plenty of solid SMGs to be running right now, like the Bullfrog or the LC-10, the MAC-10 has been my go-to sub of choice for the last few weeks because it's really fun to use, and the build we're about to go over has really manageable recoil for something with such an insane bullet hose rate of fire. Seriously, if you can get the drop on someone, you can rip through two or three of their armor plates before they can even get shots back your direction. The crazy fast fire rate is a bit of a double-edged sword in some aspects though, because to keep it balanced, of course it's got to have a lower damage output per bullet compared to something on the slower end of the fire rate spectrum like the Uzi for example. And with no attachments, the MAC-10 has got some pretty abysmal recoil, practically jumping 10 feet up in the air, hence where the 10 in MAC-10 comes from. Fun little Moo Crew fact I just made up there for you. But with how we're about to kit it out, recoil is really no issue at the ranges we'll be using it at. So let's take a look at the attachments we need to run to make sure your MAC-10 fires smooth as butter to have you melting armor and smashing puss like the frat star you are, all of course without looking like a total geed. To start getting your rocks off, you'll want to slap on the trusty old agency suppressor. This will increase your effective damage range by 10% and also reduce your vertical recoil by a little bit, both things the MAC-10 needs as much help with as it can get. With its first damage drop-off at a measly 15 meters and its second drop-off at 22 meters, a lot of its time-to-kill potential can go out the window if you're stretching your gunfights into longer territory. This agency suppressor, though, will increase these damage drop-off ranges to 17 meters and 25 meters respectively, but it's still important to remember that you can start to be outgunned by other SMGs or even ARs if you get into a gunfight outside of what you'd normally consider close-quarters combat. I myself primarily play on Rebirth Island, where a lot of the gunfights do fall in this range, so it's not that much of an issue, but if you're trying to run this on Verdansk, make sure to have a solid AR or some other primary with decent range you can use for those medium to long range engagements, and pull out the MAC-10 when you're clearing buildings or running across the map, because it's still got really good mobility even with these range boosting attachments. I'll give a few class setups after we finish going through the optimal attachments, so stick around and don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the Moo Crew if you're enjoying the video. Lastly, this agency suppressor will also keep you off the radar, which, as I've said before, is usually a good idea in any battle royale, but especially when you're running an SMG with the express purpose of getting up close and personal to other kids on the map, like that one uncle of yours you always catch stealing glimpses of you outside the bathroom window at Thanksgiving. But moving on from your Uncle Lester, since I'm sure he's just looking for a cupcake, the second attachment we'll be running is the Task Force Barrel. This one will also increase your effective damage range by another 10%, pushing your first and second damage drop-offs from the base 15 and 22 meters up to 19 and 27 meters respectively, when you run both this Task Force Barrel and the Agency Suppressor at the same time. The biggest downside to running this barrel over something like the Ranger Barrel or the Reinforced Heavy Barrel is that the Task Force Barrel does increase vertical recoil. It does also say it increases horizontal recoil, but practically all of the MAC-10's recoil is vertical in the first place, so there isn't actually any noticeable horizontal recoil increase. So you can just ignore that negative. The reason I run this barrel over the other two is because of the added strafe speed benefit in addition to the range increase and bullet velocity increase. Both of the other two barrels, the Ranger and the Reinforced Heavy, slow down your strafe speed, and the Heavy Barrel even slows down your sprinting speed. And when you're building a class all about mobility, something Uncle Lester inadvertently taught you when he escaped from that police raid last Christmas never to be seen again, movement and strafe speed can help you keep extra slippery and keep out of your enemy's crosshairs. I will say though that this is the one attachment you can feel free to experiment with on your own and switch out between the Task Force, Ranger, and Reinforced Heavy Barrels because some playstyles are different, and these three barrels all have similar benefits. It just comes down to what personal preference you have to what downside you want to pick. If you do stick with the Moo Man approved Task Force Barrel, the next attachment will help offset your vertical recoil increase you get from it. By running the Field Agent Grip, all that extra kick disappears and your recoil will be manageable once again. And do make sure to run that Field Agent Grip and not the SVOD Speed Grip, because they have the exact same recoil reducing benefits, the SVOD just also reduces overall movement speed, so stay away from that guy. Next up is the ammo attachment, where we'll be taking the Stenag 53-round drum mag for the extra bullet capacity. The double-edged sword we talked about earlier in regards to the insanely fast fire rate comes into play here once again with the magazine size. One of the bigger downsides to this weapon is that the largest mag you can equip is this 53-round one, and you can blow through most of it just downing one guy. The MAC-10 is definitely not something you should be hip-firing a lot, one because the ADS time is just really good, so why not be accurate, and two, you don't have enough bullets to afford the spray and pray methodology. Unfortunately, just like with the SVOD Speed Grip attachment, the Salvo 53-round Fast Mag doesn't actually make a difference in your reload time, it just adds a needless ADS penalty, so the best we can do is the Stenag Mag. All in all, just be careful with your shot placement and be ready to reload with every full kill with the MAC-10. Moving on to our last attachment, we'll be taking the Raider Stock, which is the real stat booster when it comes to mobility on this weapon. This stock will reduce your sprint fire time, your tactical sprint fire time, and your strafe speed while aimed down sights, all at the cost of never being able to hip fire again. But we already talked about making your shot placement count as to not run out of bullets, so that's not even really an issue. Once you've got these five attachments equipped, your MAC-10 should have really solid handling, decent recoil buffs, and of course a stupid fast fire rate. Next, you need the right class to maximize your slaying potential out in Verdansk or on Rebirth Island. My go-to overkill setup for the big boy Warzone map has me running a solid AR like the AMAX or Krig 6 with a long-range attachment setup. By the way, if you want a more in-depth weapon loadout guide for a zero-recoil Krig kit, check out the suggested video up in the top right corner. When you've got your long-range AR and close-quarters MAC-10 on the class, it's time to round out the rest of the loadout. I typically run Quick Fix for my blue perk, but you can also take EOD. For your red, you'll obviously want to take Overkill, and for your yellow perk, Amped is the way to go. I also like to take Simtexes or Thermites for my lethal, and a Heartbeat Sensor for my tactical. Once you've got your second loadout, or if you just want to run a ghosted class from the start, take the same MAC-10 build as your primary, slap on your favorite secondary, I like the full auto Psykov, and then run the same perks as before, just of course with Ghost this time instead of Overkill. The one big difference I have with this class is my tactical. If it's late enough in the game, or if I'm just feeling extra aggressive early on, I'll take a stun grenade over the Heartbeat Sensor, because they're just absolutely overpowered in final circles and are a really toxic way to get to hear fun and unique slurs hurled at you in the death chat. For Rebirth Island, I find myself a lot of times picking a ghosted AR class to start, and when I pick up my next loadout, switching my secondary Psykov out for the MAC-10 class we just went over. Whatever order of loadouts you decide to go in, you'll be well suited to surprise unsuspecting children with this MAC-10 setup. A lot like that Uncle Lester of yours we haven't seen since that news report told us he was armed and on the run a few months ago. Hey, sounds like someone's trying to get in, so let me wrap this video up by saying thanks so much for watching. If you found it helpful, please drop a like and consider subscribing to the Moo Crew for more. If you're feeling extra cheeky, come drop a follow at twitch.tv/MrMooMan11 and be first in line to witness the day I finally decide to start live streaming again. As always, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.
Hey, who are you and what are you doing in my house?
And of course, he still gets circled.
Let's move. Frag out.
Make sure he doesn't drop down low on the other side.
Stop there!
Okay.
A little right on roof.
Burn it. Grab him. Got it. No win for gold.
Fuck you guys.